Hello, my name is Evan Fraser, and I work at the University of Guelph in Ontario, Canada. As anyone who has followed this video series knows, climate change, population growth, and high energy prices mean that many experts worry farmers will struggle over the next generation to produce enough food for everyone. This video looks at how policy can make farming more sustainable and help us overcome this problem. For instance, huge amounts of data show that the modern food system is extremely wasteful. Inefficient irrigation means that we squander vast amounts of precious water, while many farmers apply more fertilizers than plants can use. These excess nutrients run off fields and pollute rivers and lakes. What's worse, Westerners waste between 30 and 50% of the food we buy. Surely if we simply cleaned up our act, we wouldn't have to worry so much about the future of our food system, right? Economists give us a way to think about this problem by talking about negative externalities. Negative externalities are costs of producing food that the market doesn't account for. For instance, if a farmer doesn't pay for the water he or she uses, then the value of the water would be external to the price the consumer pays for the food, and hence there would be no incentive for the farmer to conserve this resource. Similarly, if a farmer pollutes a river, and the price of the food from that farm doesn't include the price of cleaning up the river, then the cost of pollution is another negative externality. These hidden costs mean farmers who waste resources or pollute the environment actually do better economically than farmers who steward their land. For instance, if farmers don't pay for the water they use, then a farmer who uses inefficient irrigation may be able to offer consumers cheaper food than a farmer who spends her or his money investing in more efficient watering systems. In the 1990s, a group of scientists calculated that, in the United Kingdom, externalities like polluted water, damaged habitats, soil erosion, and food poisoning caused 2.3 billion pounds worth of damages in 1996 alone. The British royal family was not amused. Prince Charles regularly talks about the future of farming, where he argues that we need to include in the bottom line the true costs of food production, the true financial costs, and the true cost to the earth. Many argue that because of negative externalities, policies are needed to ensure that farmers, processors, retailers, and consumers pay the full cost of producing our food. There are a number of ways of doing this. One is to pass laws that make farmers pay for the things they use from the environment. Mostly this has been tried in irrigated farming systems where countries have experimented with charging farmers more for the water they draw from aquifers or wells. Another way is by paying farmers for ecosystem services, which is a fancy way of saying the things that the environment gives us. For instance, the European Union has policies that pay farmers for maintaining wildlife habitat and biodiversity. This is useful because it creates an incentive for farmers to tolerate wildlife that might otherwise simply be seen as a pest. A third approach is to tax pollution or waste. If policies are enacted that make us bear the full price of our food, then it stands to reason that food prices will go up. And if food prices rise, it also stands to reason that we will throw less out. This may be a particularly useful strategy in terms of getting consumers in the West, who throw out huge amounts of food, to become more efficient. But while such approaches may sound ideal, there may be unintended negative consequences. In particular, policies that force consumers to bear the full cost of their food might also cause a rise in food insecurity and malnutrition for those consumers who could not afford to pay more for food. So, while it is vitally important for policymakers to develop strategies to correct negative externalities, such strategies must go hand in hand with other policies to protect the poor from the negative effects of price increases. If you're interested in learning more about this and other topics on Feeding 9 Billion, you can check out the other videos in this series. Also, my recent book, Empires of Food, goes into these topics in detail. And you can, of course, find me on Facebook and Twitter, where I regularly post news on global food security. Finally, if there's anything in this video that you want to follow up on, head over to www.feeding9billion.com, where I've posted all the scripts I've used in these videos, along with background references, and opened up an online discussion where you can weigh in with your own thoughts on anything you've just heard.